young son critically injured on their way home from daycare.
It is just senseless that someone would drive erratically and put other people's lives at jeopardy.
How a robbery and chase led to this devastating crash.
And tonight, that father and son are in critical condition. The robbery suspect is in jail.
This started yesterday afternoon in Sherburne County, and police say that a man robbed a bar in Big Lake, then led them on a chase to Monticello. Investigators say the suspect was driving the wrong way on County Road 39 when he hit another car at Broadway. And 5 Eyewitness News reporter Joe Mason is live tonight at North Memorial Medical Center in Robbinsdale, where those two victims were taken. Joe.
Leah, the family is devastated tonight. I spoke to them over the phone just a few hours ago. They're still dealing with the shock and sadness of this accident. And all they ask for tonight is everyone's prayers.
An amazing father. He's one in a million. When God made him, they broke the mold. That's how the sister of Travis Colas describes her 28-year-old brother. And now we fade to black. Because it's so dark, so difficult to think about what happened here at this intersection in Monticello Monday night. After picking up his one-year-old son, Layton, from daycare, Travis was on his way home for dinner. And again, we fade to black. Because this photo shows us how life can change in a moment. That Chevy Suburban there smashed into Travis's car. Authorities say the man driving the SUV was 47-year-old Kevin Green. He was trying to get away from police after robbing Tootsie's Tavern in Big Lake.
I feel for the family that was involved in the accident. It's just senseless.
We met Teresa Brady at the tavern where Green is accused of robbing a woman working the pull tab booth.
She was counting some money in one of the drawers and he had reached over and put his hand out and indicated, give me the money. He had said he had a gun.
Green took off with $500 in cash. Police say a chase started and Green ended up going the wrong way at that intersection, causing the crash. Green didn't get hurt badly, but Travis and his son did.
Too soon to say if there's really anything they could have done to avoid it, other than the driver not fleeing the police.
And now a family prays that the father with the amazing heart in his boy will survive.
The Colas Family Fund has been set up at the Bank of Elk River to help pay for some of the mounting medical bills. You can find more information on that fund by going to our website, kstp.com. Green faces several charges in this crime. And by the way, Travis and his wife are expecting their second child in September. Live in Robbinsdale, Joe Mason, 5 Eyewitness News.
The Minnesota Department of Public Safety does have police pursuit guidelines posted on its website. It says that a pursuit should only start if there is a reasonable chance that the suspect will be caught. Factors behind continuing the pursuit include the crime the suspect committed, traffic in the area, and weather conditions. State Patrol says that these are decisions, though, that have to be made quickly.
That's always a delicate balance between public safety and the need to apprehend someone.
The first police cruiser in a pursuit is advised to stay close to the suspect. Backup units are supposed to stay back at a safe distance.
We have new details tonight in the death of a Western Wisconsin toddler. The Polk County Sheriff's Office has now confirmed the keys to the car where 2-year-old Isaiah Thies' body was found were in the trunk with the boy. They also addressed the time of his death. Because of the temperature inside the trunk, medical examiners estimate that Isaiah would not have survived past about 9 p.m. That's the same time that he was reported missing to police. That means even if searchers had found him, it likely would have been too late. Isaiah will be laid to rest tomorrow. For details on that and to contribute to a memorial fund for the family, head to kstp.com under links. A 5-year-old boy is in critical condition tonight after falling.